Hello. Hey, good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to the New Orleans Jazz Museum. My name is Jim Sisko, and I'm a director of the jazz program at Bellevue College. It's a little community college just outside of Seattle, and we've been making frequent trips down to New Orleans, which has been pretty awesome over the last 12 years or so. And this is always one of the highlights of our trips, coming down here and playing. And we have a dear friend, a wonderful saxophonist from New Orleans, who spent a little bit of time in Seattle, who's going to be a guest artist with us today. So enough of that. Let's get into some music. First tune we're going to play for you is a tune that was played by the great Terry Gibbs, a vibraphonist out of L.A., and it's a tune entitled The Claw. Thank you. That was the Claw. And we're not going to waste any time getting our guest artists up, but just a little bit of something. You know, the music that's come out of New Orleans is really a small group music, traditionally. But those small groups continued to grow into the early big band era, where Duke Ellington and Count Basie and others took over. But there's a rich history of small group instrumentalists and small group arrangements that are built into big band tunes. This is a great case of that. This is a tune written by the great Nat Adderley, brother of Cannibal Adderley. And it's a tune entitled Cyclops, and it's arranged by one of the greatest musicians in the history of American music, Oliver Nelson, who was a wonderful saxophonist as well. So we're going to feature New Orleans native Rex Gregory on the alto saxophone on Nat Adderley's tune entitled Cyclops.
Thank you.
Rex Gregory on the alto saxophone, Taylor Russell on the tenor, and Joe Friedman back there on the trumpet. That was Nat Adderley's great tune entitled Cyclops. You know, just because this is a museum and there's some history components, I may as well share some of that stuff. You know, as big bands rolled along, so much of the music that was created in the history of jazz was an evolution of what happened on the stage. And then over time, as the ensembles got bigger, it was harder to really make things happen organically with a very large ensemble, outside of just riff tunes and people calling out things and making it happen. So eventually, in stepped arrangers, Fletcher Henderson, obviously Duke Ellington and others. And then in this middle big band period, the big band really was the king of popular music in the late 30s and early 40s, and hung on a little bit longer. And the arrangers were really people that ended up being, in some ways, stars. And they wrote specifically for people. So one of those people that was a really wonderful soloist in that period was Benny Goodman. And he played a lot on a tune entitled Stompin' at the Savoy. And this is a modern arrangement, a much modern, probably written in the last 15 years or so, by an arranger from Germany. I won't even try. Well, I will. Peter Herbolzheimer is his last name. But this is a great arrangement, a modern treatment of Stompin' at the Savoy, and it's going to feature Rex on the clarinet.
Thank you.
ex-Gregory again on the clarinet on the wonderful tune entitled Stompin' at the Savoy. We knew we had to come to New Orleans and have something feature the clarinet. It's such an important instrument in the history of this music. Okay, we're going to move on to, really, in my opinion, the greatest arranger and composer in American history. This is a tune that was written by the great Duke Ellington, and it's entitled Sophisticated Lady. And again, like that last tune, this is a little bit more of a modern treatment of this tune. And that's kind of the cool thing about all music. It continues to evolve, and we still appreciate all these wonderful melodies, but people are always getting their hands in there and putting a new twist on some of these beautiful tunes. And you really can't do any better than Duke. So this is going to feature Rex again on a beautiful tune entitled Sophisticated Lady. And before I forget, would you mind thanking our wonderful sound man back there, Travis? How about a hand for Travis for making it sound so great here in this wonderful space? And thank you to all the folks down here at the Jazz Museum to make these opportunities happen for performers and for folks like you that appreciate good music. Sophisticated Lady. Thank you. sophisticated lady, Rex Gregory. How about another hand for Rex Gregory? We're gonna give Rex a little bit of a break and bring him back for our last tune in just a second. And I'm gonna call an audible here. Yeah, let's do exactly like this. Okay. This is the first time we've played with Rex, so that was kind of fun. Honestly, we came down and we chatted about the tunes. We played for like 10 minutes before the show, and it's a thrill for folks like this on stage. You get to hear a master musician like that, someone who's really can do it all, and it's a treat for us. So thank you, Rex, for being here today. Okay, we're going to play a nice big band standard, a tune entitled Exactly Like This, and another feature along the history of big band music and small group music is that there are standard tunes, songs that we all learn and know, and then people have come along, and Charlie Parker was the most notable musician for writing tunes, new melodies on existing chord changes. He took a number of old tunes. In fact, the one that gets played all the time, standard, it gets played a ton in New Orleans, is Way Back Home in Indiana. And then over the top of that, he wrote a great tune entitled Donna Lee. This is an example of a tune just like this. Tune's entitled Exactly Like This, and it's basically roughly based on Ellington's chord changes to Take the A Train. So this is Exactly Like This, and it's going to feature Roman on the piano and Joe on the trumpet and Akash on the baritone sax.
Let's do a chorus each, okay? So one up top, one each in the middle of the solo section, okay?
Okay.
All right. Yep, start at 33. One, two, three.
That was Akash Singh on the baritone saxophone. And you heard from our great drummer back there, Henry Moore on the drums. Yeah. Roman Gorin on the piano. And Joe Friedman again on the trumpet back there. One of the kind of fun things about the school I teach at, it's a community college. And so we've got a range of players. I've got a few folks in here. In fact, every soloist on that tune is actually a high school student. So we integrate what we call Running Start at our school. So we have high school students that take part in college courses. And I've got a bunch of college students that are in here. And I've got some members of the community who are back and playing music and doing it because they love it. And they're working day jobs doing other stuff. So it's kind of the unique thing about our school, which is fun and which is a great thing for people to be have the opportunity to play together. So those were all high school students taking solos on that tune. Let's do... And then we'll bring Rex up to finish the set. Okay, we're going to play a tune written by a great musician from Kansas City by the name of Benny Moten. And this tune was made famous by the Count Basie Orchestra. And it's going to feature a few folks on this. Joe again on the trumpet and Taylor on the tenor saxophone. Moten Swing. Thank you. you. That was the great Moton Swing by the Count Basie Big Band. Okay, we're going to bring up Rex Gregory for one last tune. Thank you again for coming here this afternoon. Nice to be inside when it's nice and cool on a hot day in New Orleans. And we're going to feature Rex on the tune written by a great arranger by the name of Matt Harris entitled El Gatote.
Thank you.
Rex Gregory and the Bellevue College Jazz Orchestra. Thank you again to Travis and all the good folks here at the New Orleans Jazz Museum. And if you're in town, Saturday night, Rex is going to be playing with New Orleans Jazz Orchestra, right?
Yeah.
Playing the music of Prince at the Jazz Marketplace?
Yeah, New Orleans Jazz Market. Oh, Lucy Haley over there. Yeah.
Wonderful venue, amazing pro band of some of the greatest players in the region, and playing some really unique arrangements of the music of Prince. So, you know, if you have some time on Saturday, make your way over there and enjoy the music. Thank you again for coming out. Have a great evening, and be safe. Thank you.